How are you guys doing?
Can you update us on the injuries to Romelu and Timo?
Well, maybe I know not much more than you do, and you saw it. Romelu twisted his ankle in the foul in the box, and Timo has a hamstring injury. So will take a while for both of them. We need more examinations to be more precise, but they will be out for some for some matches.
Mark McAdam.
Thomas, based on what you said in the build-up to the game, you sort of led us to believe that Romelu would be rested because of the mental fatigue, and you thought he perhaps had played too many games recently.
Yeah.
When you look in hindsight now at what's happened coming off after 23 minutes, is this a decision to start him something you now regret, having said that you're going to be losing him for a few games?
Yeah, if I knew it before, I would not have done it. But how can you know it before? And it was necessary that he was on the pitch. He started very strong. We spoke about it. I spoke about him with him about the situation that I think that he carries a bit of a mental fatigue around with him, and that I think it's also normal. But he's our number nine. He's our reference up front, and the best thing against the mental fatigue is a goal. And we knew that we can be the dominant team, and we knew that we build around today a fast attack with Mason and with Timo around him, and him on the reference up front in the middle. And I had the strong belief that he can in a Champions League match turn things around and turn things around in terms of scoring and being decisive, what he actually did, because he was super strong in our start, and he took the foul. So maybe without him, maybe it's not 2-0. So no, I don't regret it, because it's not a muscle injury and a fatigue from a physical fatigue. He is more a little bit overplayed. This is my opinion. Maybe I'm not even right. And it was the moment to give him confidence and let him play. And I don't regret it, because he was decisive, and things like this can happen. It's bad luck.
Nizar Kinsella.
Hi, Thomas.
Hi.
I wanted to talk about Kai Havertz and Callum Hudson-Odoi. How much is this also an opportunity for them to get back into their best form, and maybe even Hudson-Odoi in his best position as well?
Always a chance, and always necessary to prove it. Prove a point now. So we will have some games without Romelu. We will have some games without Timo. So everybody is invited to join the race for minutes on the pitch. And when they're on the pitch, they need to show the hunger and the determination to be decisive, to be in the box. And this is how it is, and they did today, and there's still room to improve. And Saturday we need the same performance, the same hunger, the same determination from whomever starts for us, because we need goals to win matches, and we want to find solution without Romelu and Timo. That's clear, and everybody will join this race to be decisive for us.
Okay, last question, James Robson.
Hi, Thomas. With Norwich at the weekend, and that's an early kickoff, and against a side today that you were very much expected to win and you won comfortably, it's a very strong team that you played. Is that evidence of how important you thought it was to get a win after losing to Juve, or just evidence of you take each game as it comes and it's your best team every time?
We take the game step by step. There's no more important game than the game we actually play on this very match day. We pick the guys. Shoshi did not play, for example, in the last match in Brentford. We went again for Ruben because he was there during national break. So the guys who are on the pitch deserve to start. And there are no gifts handed, and there is no resting players because the next game is a little bit more important or whatever. We put the best lineup in our belief to have the best chance to beat Brentford in Brentford, and then we put the best lineup on this very day. Today was a Wednesday to beat whoever arrives in a Champions League match, and the next one is like you said, is Saturday 12:30, and we will put again the best team. So we will have to check now the datas. We have to be very professional in recovery, because It will be an easy preparation. We want the same performance again. This will be maybe one of the shortest meetings, pre-match meetings in my history of coaching, because it's we want everything on the same level, same energy, same amount of sprints, same deep runs, same ball wins, and same effort. And we have the chance to switch on some positions, to have to demand from everybody physically the same input, and then let's see.
Okay, we'll leave it there. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, bye.